Good morning, students. Today we'll see the facial artery. So this is a mid sagittal section of the head and neck region. This is the mid sagittal section of your head and neck region. This is your eye, this is your nose, this is your mouth, and this is your chin. So we are looking at this section from its lateral side. This is the face area, this is your neck region, this is your sternocleidomastoid muscle, this one is your submandibular gland, and this is your masseter muscle. So this is the masseter muscle, and this is your base of the mandible. So facial artery is a anterior branch of the external carotid artery. It arises in relation to the carotid triangle, and then it comes into the face. Before coming into the face, in the neck region, it makes an arch around the base of the mandible in relation to this submandibular gland, and then it enters into the face near the anteroinferior angle of this masseter muscle. This is the anterior border of the masseter muscle, and this is the anteroinferior angle, and this is the base. Over this point, it comes into the face. If you see the artery, it is a tortuous in nature. This is how the tortuosity of the artery you can see. This is the tortuous artery, and it gives several branches into the face. First, it gives the branches, that is your inferior labial artery. This is your inferior labial artery, and it supplies the lower lip area. Then further, if you trace it upwards, it gives the another branches, that is your, this one is your superior labial artery. So this is your superior labial artery, this is your superior labial artery, to supply the area of the upper lip. Further, it gives the lateral nasal artery to supply this nose. This is your nose part. If you trace it further upward, if I am retracting these muscles, it goes upward over here, and then reaches up to the middle angle of the eye. Over here it forms what is known as the angular artery, and then here it ends by anastomosing with the dorsal nasal branch of the ophthalmic artery, which is ultimately is a branch of internal carotid artery. So this is a, over here it is an anastomosis between the external and the internal carotid artery. Now further, if you see behind this facial artery, this one is your facial vein. So this is your facial vein, which lies in relation to the posterior part of the facial artery. So this is your facial vein. You can palpate the palpation of this artery in relation to your base of the mandible, in relation to the anteroinferior angle of the masseter muscle.